In airgunning circles, the calibre controversy has raged since time immemorial. 177 for its higher velocity, flatter trajectory, smaller surface area and greater penetration. 22 because it's got a larger surface area, holds its velocity downrange much better and has greater shocking power at the target. Then there's 20 calibre, supposedly the best of both the 177 and 22 worlds. And let's not forget the quarter-inch exponents of the 2.5 caliber, who love its extra shocking power, particularly when shot from rifles with a muzzle energy in excess of 20 foot-pounds. But now there's another one in the mix, namely the Rangemaster Emperor, a big badass pellet that's been designed specifically around the brand new 100 foot-pound Daystate Wolverine PCP. OMG, they've only gone and given us a 303 caliber air rifle.
Yes, I did say 303 caliber. It's the brand spanking new Wolverine 303 from leading UK airgun maker Daystate, a conventional and stunning looking pre-charged pneumatic that comes dressed in sumptuous ambidextrous walnut stock with a height adjustable butt and twin-sided cheekpiece. A reversible bolt cycles a 5-shot auto-loading magazine, which sits in a titanium breech that contrasts beautifully with the matte black oversized air cylinder, above which sits the specially made 303 caliber barrel, choked at the threaded muzzle and contained in a sound-suppressing shroud. An auto-safety and delightful adjustable trigger complete this uber-powerful package. The Wolverine spits out its 51-grain Emperors at over 950 feet per second. A muzzle energy in excess of 100 foot-pounds. Of course, credentials like that mean it's no plinker. And once you've squirted 250 bars worth of air into the Wolverine's 300cc air cylinder, courtesy of Daystate's usual quick-fill charging system, for the record, you'll definitely want to use a scuba tank rather than a manual pump here, you only get a return of around 10 shots before, at 200 bar, the rifle needs topping back up. Yep, only 10, but hey, what do you expect when those 10 add up to 1,000 foot-pounds of firepower between them? Like I said, it ain't no plinker, but a serious piece of kit for field work. Though Daystate hasn't just come up with a high-velocity airgun, they've also got its design right. Big and powerful it may be, but the Wolverine handles beautifully, most notably thanks to its stock.
The woodwork is truly ambidextrous. And the cheekpiece is profiled on both sides of the butt and you get perfect eye alignment with the scope. And what's more, there's a height adjustable butt pad, so whether you're shooting uphill or downhill, you'll have no problem with gun fit whatsoever. And the stippling has been beautifully executed. On the pistol grip, it affords you a really good hold for your trigger hand. But I have to say, as beautiful as it looks, the stippling on the forestock is just a little bit too far back. In terms of practicality, you really want your leading hand a little further forward on the forestock, when the gun itself then balances beautifully in the shoulder.
Speaking of the forestock, it's chunky but not so deep as to be a handful, giving plenty of room for different hold points, and it's been nicely rounded underneath, where Daystate's logo has been laser etched into the wood, along with an onboard manometer, so you always know the rifle's fill state. Given the Wolverine's low shot count, this gauge is important. You'll be using the gun at long range, where any drop in velocity will be very noticeable.
And the distances over which this rifle is capable of shooting means it's really important that you eliminate cant. That's why I fitted an AccuCover scope cap to my MTC Genesis.
Cant's one thing. You also need to be on top of your game when you're shooting over distances out to and in excess of 100 yards. Because even in a PCP, 100 foot-pounds does create more muzzle movement than you'll be used to on lesser-powered air rifles. But don't think the Wolverine's all power and no accuracy. Here's a typical 5-shot group with the Emperors at 50 yards. And here's another, in less than ideal conditions I should add, at 75 yards. I'm aiming dead centre, so you can get an idea of the drop at 75 yards with a 50-yard zero.
Wow. Well, it is a phenomenally accurate air rifle, and actually the Emperor is travelling at 950 feet per second. That means it's in the barrel for all of, well, by rough calculation I'd say 2 milliseconds. Yeah, I cheated, I've already worked that out. But 2 milliseconds means it's a very, very forgiving rifle. So even if you think you've pulled the shot off, you haven't. And what I can't get over is the size of the holes it makes. If it can do that to a paper target, just think what it's going to do to live quarry.
Well, let's not think live quarry, that'd be too gory for Airgun TV. But we can let our imagination run wild with red dye and a few other simulated targets of a soft tissue nature.
Ugh, what a mess. Tomato anyone?
No thanks. But if you really want to see the mess a 50 grain airgun pellet makes at 100 foot-pounds, then take a look at this carnage.
That is pretty impressive. I mean, I have never seen a tin can get as mangled as that with one shot. That's what a 303 caliber Rangemaster Emperor can do. And of all the fruit I shot, this is the only bit I could find of one of the plums, and there really isn't much left of it anyway. Don't know where the stone went, probably shattered to a million pieces. But if that's what it can do to fruit, just think what it's going to do to the pests on my shoot. Wouldn't like to be in their shoes right now.
No, indeed. And it gets worse for the vermin. The Wolverine runs a 5-shot magazine that automatically breaches the next shot with a swift cycle of the bolt. And even though this Daystate's spitting out in excess of 100 foot-pounds, the bolt cocks with no more effort than any other PCP. Although I have to admit that loading up the rotary magazine with 303 caliber Emperors is a lot more finger-friendly than fiddling around with my normal 177s. I've loaded the mag from the left here, but it can also be fed into the breech from the right. It's a system that suits southpaws, who will also be pleased that the Wolverine's bolt can be swapped over for dedicated left-hand use in little more than 60 seconds too. There's a short clip of how to do the conversion right at the end of this review. What's more, because of its power, Daystate has designed the Wolverine such that its trigger is rendered completely inoperable as soon as the bolt's opened. Like the bolt, the trigger let-off is what you'd expect from a less powerful PCP too. Its curved blade may have to unleash 50-plus grain ammo at nearly 1,000 feet per second, but its two-stage operation breaks away the shot with total control. And the manual safety catch is probably the most solidly engineered unit I've ever seen on an air rifle. Just as well, really, given the Wolverine's phenomenal power output. And one other thing. The grip of this sporter stock has been sculpted for a thumb-up position, the best hold for proper trigger attack in my opinion. Oh, and in case you're worried about those heavy pellets getting jammed up the barrel, fear not. The Wolverine's patented air-driven indexing system has been designed to not rotate the magazine to the next shot as soon as the main cylinder's air pressure drops below a certain level. Like the rest of the rifle. Ingenious.
And that's the Wolverine 303, a brand new PCP air rifle with a brand new airgun caliber to boot. I think they're both going to catch on, but there will be people that question why has Daystate produced a 100 foot-pound air rifle? Well, why not? They can and they have. And if it's long-range hunting that you're into, well, there ain't going to be much to beat this, that's for sure. Side by side, you get a full idea of the scale of difference between the two calibres. There's a 177, 8.3 grains, and there's a whopping 303 Emperor, 51 grains, or the best part of.
The Wolverine's bolt can be reversed for true left-handed use in less than a minute. With the rifle empty, draw back the bolt, but don't actually cock the gun, and remove the small brass screw. Then use a 5mm hex key to undo the caphead bolt at the rear, so that you can then slide off the stainless bolt handle. Now replace the brass screw in its other slot. Turn the bolt handle around 180 degrees and affix it by reattaching the cap head bolt. Leave the handle angled like this, so that when you push the bolt home and lock it, it doesn't snag on the woodwork. Job done.